In this video, we're going to keep working on our custom audio player within React. Seems like there's some bugs in here. Ugh. In the last video, we started building a custom audio player within React. This is the same audio player that you'll see on the compress.fm site. I have quite the feature set planned for this player. We're going to create bookmarks, refactor our code into a custom hook library that we can turn into an NPM package, set it up to handle multiple audio players on a page. So hitting play on one player will stop another player on the same page. Lots of fun content. All of this will appear in a multiple video series. So be sure to hit subscribe below, or even better, hit the bell icon so you don't miss a thing. In this particular video, we're going to be talking about how to debug within VS Code. That's right, after I recorded the last video, I noticed a bug. Fortunate for us, VS Code gives us some great tools for debugging that are far more powerful than just console.log. So today, I'm gonna show you how to use them. Before we get started, I wanted to point out that I've created timestamps and listed them in the description below. Feel free to jump around, especially if you're coming back and using this video for reference. With all that said, let's look at the bug. If you wanna follow along, you can download or clone the GitHub repo. There will be a link in the description below. Then, inside the terminal, you'll need to run npm install. This will grab all the dependencies. Next up, we'll want to run npm run dev, and this will get our project up and running within our browser on localhost 3000. If we look at this in the browser and hit our forward 30 button, it jumps forward 30 seconds. That's great. But if we hit it again, the playhead jumps to the very end of our clip. So that's a minute and 15 seconds. That's wrong. It should be exactly 1 minute. So let's try one more thing. If I drag the knob back to the very beginning and hit the play button, and then I hit the forward 30, it jumps to the very end. So kind of strange. Very unexpected behavior. If we experiment with our backward 30 button, it seems to be working fine. With the playhead at the end, I can click it twice and it will jump back the appropriate amount. I can also hit the play button and then hit the backward 30 button and it still jumps back the appropriate amount. Let's open up our code within VS Code, and our entire component is controlled through this audioplayer.js file. If we scroll down to where this is being implemented, so here we have our back 30. I'm going to hide the sidebar real quick. We have our backward 30 button and our forward 30 button. And the back 30 button has an onClick event handler that's calling the back 30 function, which is right here. And the forward 30 button has an onClick event handler that's calling the forward 30 button. This makes it even stranger because the code within each of these functions is very similar. The only difference is one is adding and the other is subtracting. In the past, I probably would have reached for console.log. Super easy, right? We can just jump into our forward 30 function and add a console.log statement before we change the value of progressBar.Current.Value. We can also duplicate this and check that same value after we've updated. This way we can know what the value is at the beginning before we do anything, and then at the end to make sure that our 30 seconds was added correctly. I'm gonna give this a save and open it within the browser. And I'm gonna open my Chrome DevTools by hitting Command Option I. And I have the console tab activated. Now I'm gonna hit our forward 30 button and the console reads out 0 and 30. Perfect. Let's hit it again. And now we see 30 and 75. So somewhere along the way, it added an extra 15. So it's passing in the right amount, but somehow it's not adding 30 correctly. Let's look at how we can get the same information a couple of different ways directly within VS Code. And really the code here isn't too complicated, but as we're trying to debug harder, more complex problems, these tools are invaluable. Plus, it starts to close the gap. Right now we're writing our code in VS Code and troubleshooting in the web browser. If we can make use of these debug tools, we'll be inspecting our code and fixing the bugs right within the code. So, to the code. So the first thing that we want to do is go to our debugger panel. This is in the sidebar. So the fourth icon down, it looks like a play button with a bug on top. So if we click on that, our sidebar changes and we have several options. So let's click on run and debug, and this will launch a command panel within VS Code. And I may have more options than you, and that's okay, but I'm going to select Chrome, not the legacy version, just Chrome. So I'm going to hit enter. And this will create a preference file for us. And if we go back to our Explorer panel, in the root of our project, if there wasn't one already, there is now a .vs code folder. And inside is our launch.json file that we just created. And this file lists out a few things. It says that we are using Chrome. There's a brief description. There's a URL saying where it's going to run, and then it has a dynamic web root. The only thing that we need to change here is the URL. Remember, when we run npm run dev, we can view our project on localhost 3000. So we need this URL to match. So let's change 8080 to 3000 and give it a save. Cool. Now let's go back to our debug panel, and we have a few different options available to us. Now I could explain what appears in each of these, but let's get some data in there first. Now remember, our server is still running and we can see our project within Chrome. That's important. Now let's hit the play button at the top of our panel. I'm going to close this, and here's our play button. And I want to point out, I'm not clicking on the words launch Chrome or the drop-down arrow. If I do that, a drop-down menu will appear. I'm not clicking on any of that. I'm clicking on this play button. Okay, so that launches another Chrome window. And you can tell this is one from VS Code because it doesn't have any of my bookmarks along the top. So I actually have two instances of Chrome running. Let's go back to our actual code. Let's add a breakpoint within VS Code. A breakpoint is just what it sounds like. It's a point in your code where you want to take a break. Our code will pause in the middle of its process and we can take a look around. So to add a breakpoint, you can just click to the left of the number and a red dot will appear. And maybe you've seen this before by accident. You can remove it by clicking on the red dot again and it will go away. I'm going to remove our console.log statements from before, but I'm going to leave a blank line before and after our statement and add our breakpoints there. So I'm going to go over to Chrome, and you want to make sure that you're not in your application version of Chrome. So you have all those bookmarks. You want to make sure that you are in your VS Code version of Chrome. Now remember, to get this to work, we added our breakpoints within the forward 30 function. So we need to click on the forward 30 button to trigger it. So if I do that within the debugger browser, as soon as I clicked that button, it actually kicked me back to VS Code. One of the things that you may notice is that the breakpoint that our code stopped at has a triangle around it and the line is highlighted. Now there's a lot more information in our side panel. So at the top, we have some variables and their current values. And we're assigning a value in our function, but we really don't have any variables. So let's add one just to see what happens. So I'm gonna say const hello equals world. And to stop the debugger, you can just click on this stop button, and then I can hit the play button again to start up our app. Okay, so within Chrome, I'm gonna hit the forward 30 button, and this time you'll see hello in the sidebar. And it says undefined because we're on the same line where it's going to make that assignment. So if I hit continue, so I'm gonna click the button to continue, our app will continue playing until it hits the next breakpoint. And now our hello variable equals world. So that's pretty cool. We can also expand our closure. And you can see in parentheses, this is an auto player. We can see all the assignments that have been made. So I'm gonna expand this down. There we go. So for example, right now our duration is 75 seconds and is playing is set to false. So very helpful. Let's look at some more of the panels in our sidebar. I'm going to come back to watch. So let's go to call stack. And you can see all the items that are being called. And the most recent is listed at the top. So here you can see that we have our forward 30 function was called inside our components autoplayer.js file. In the loaded scripts panel, you can see all the scripts that are being loaded. Then at the bottom, we have our breakpoints. And you can see right now we have two custom ones added on line 67 and 70 inside autoplayer.js. And we can uncheck these and it will skip over those breakpoints. So I skipped the watch panel, but I want to come back to it. Here, we can create different expressions to watch for. We're trying to evaluate our progress bar value. So I'm going to click on the plus button and add that to our list. And we can actually just copy and paste. So I'm gonna hit enter. And right away, you can see that it has a value of 30. So let's hit the continue button again. Then in Chrome, I'm going to hit the forward 30 button. In VS Code, in our watch panel, our progress bar value is at 30. Then if we hit the continue button again, our value will get set and it's at 75. Again, revealing our bug. There are a few other things we can do to get the same data out. We can hover over these items within our code, and a little tooltip will appear with the value. Another method, we can create different kinds of breakpoints. So I'm gonna stop the debugger. So I'm gonna click on the stop button. And while we're setting things up, let's go ahead and remove our hello variable since that's dummy code. And I'm also gonna remove our two existing breakpoints. And this is kind of interesting. If the debugger is not running, I can only set a breakpoint for the entire line. But if I go ahead and hit play, then a dot appears in front of the number. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on that dot. And within the breakpoints panel, you can see that I now have two breakpoints created. Here, 68 is the line number, and the 5, or 33, is the column number. So columns are vertical, so if I start at the far left, the fifth character over is where our line really starts because of the indentation. The second breakpoint is the 33rd character over. So this is kind of nice. You can tell exactly where in the line the breakpoint is set. Okay, I'm going to get rid of our second breakpoint. I'm going to right-click on our breakpoint, and you can see that I can select Edit Breakpoint. And you'll see this little panel up here. And here I can enter an expression. And this is the same thing as a conditional breakpoint. Maybe I only want this to break if I'm past the 35 second mark. So within the bar, I'm gonna type progress bar dot current dot value is greater than 35. So that has to evaluate either true or false. Now let's test this out. So I'm gonna hit enter. In the debugger browser, I'm gonna hit the forward 30 button. And nothing happens. Let's hit it again, and still nothing happens. So let's add another breakpoint further down that will stop the code no matter what. So if we test this out, I'm gonna move this so it'll go past the 30 second mark. Okay, so if I hit forward 30, it is past the 30 second mark, and it got stopped on line 70. So it should be triggering, it's breaking, but it's hitting the second breakpoint. And in our watch panel, it's reading a value of 75. So that's really strange. For some reason, our expression isn't being triggered. And actually, it's not that strange. It's not triggering because it's not related to our bug, but we'll get to that. Okay, let's look at a few more options we have. I'm going to stop our debugger and remove our existing breakpoints. Okay, and I'm gonna add, let's say remove breakpoint, and I'm gonna add a new one. And this time, I'm going to click on the drop down and select hit counter. This is helpful if you're running a loop and want to trigger it after the loop's been hit a certain number of times. Here we're going to trigger it after we've hit the forward 30 function twice. So we can say greater than or equal to 2. So I'm going to hit enter and let's test this out. So I'm going to start our debugger. And I'm going to hit the forward 30 button. Nothing happens. That's fine. I've only hit it once. Hit the second one, and that hits our breakpoint. Okay, so let's look at the last option. Create a new one. I'm going to edit it, and this time I'm going to select log message from the dropdown. And this is very similar to our console.log, but we don't have to worry about removing them from our code for production. This is actually just like string interpolation. So we need to add curly brackets, and I'm gonna say progress bar dot current dot value, and then I'm gonna hit enter. I'm gonna create a second breakpoint after the assignment, and instead of clicking on the gutter first to create the breakpoint and then clicking edit, I'm actually going to do this all at once just by right-clicking and selecting add log point. So I wanna say the exact same thing here. So I'm gonna paste in that same progress bar dot current dot value. So I'm gonna hit enter. I also wanted to point out that I can hover over this point and the tooltip will give me more information. Okay, so let's hit play. And I'm going to hit my forward 30 button. And it might look like nothing happened. It didn't send us back to VS Code like it did with our other breakpoints. And if I look in my terminal, nothing's there. if I look in the terminal within VS Code, nothing's here either, but there is a debug console. So if I click on that, we can see our two log points. When it hits the first log point, our progress bar is 0, and then when it leaves, it's 30. So let's hit our forward 30 button again. And this time it's 30 and 75. So before I explain what's really going on, I want to show you one more trick, last trick. Let's jump back over to Chrome, but this time I'm going to pull up my developer tools. So Command-Alt-I. In our console, you'll see the exact same readout that we had in our console terminal. If we click on the sources panel, you'll see a lot of the same elements that are within VS Code, and they work here the exact same way. So let's go over to VS Code and add a regular breakpoint within our code. Then in Chrome, let's come over and hit our forward 30 button again. And if we go back to Chrome, since our dev tools are open, we can actually advance our code directly within Chrome right here. Cool. Okay, have you figured out where the bug is? Let's go back to VS Code and I'll close that panel and I'll explain what's happening. Okay, the value that's getting returned from our input is not a number, it's a string, and you can't add 30 to a string. I mean, I know our code is trying, but it's obviously creating bugs. We tried casting it to a number with the JavaScript number method, but we're casting it after it has already tried to do the math. So let's fix this so that it casts our value into a number and then it adds 30. And I'm going to do this to the back 30 button as well. Okay, I'm going to restart our debugger. So I'm going to hit stop and make sure everything's saved. I'm going to hit play. Now, if we test this out, let's hit continue. Everything is working and you can see it's 60. Okay, done. As always, the final code is posted on GitHub, link in the description below. Feel free to fork it, download it, modify it, use it, whatever, it's yours. And as I mentioned before, this is a multi-part series. In the next video, we'll cover how to add a bookmark or chapter. So if you like this video and want to see more videos on web design and development, be sure to hit the subscribe button below. Hit the bell icon to receive notifications when new videos are posted. Until then, keep coding. Many of you may or may not know, I work for a company called Zeal, and they actually underwrite my channel. That's right, they wholeheartedly support what I'm doing on the YouTubes. Frankly, I don't know many companies that will do that. In fact, most companies don't even want you to have side projects, and in my case, Zeal not only encourages it, but they support it. Anyway, they're hiring, so if you're looking for a job, or even if you're not, but you want to work for a great company, plus you get to work with me, check out their website for the job listing. I'll include a link in the description below.